do you turn that thing wide?
Let me go check with him.
There is
Someone up here in the choir says, Slava Ukraini, you have to answer me. And the answer is, Heroyam Slava.
Heroyam Slava.
Try it.
Heroyam Slava.
Which means glory to the heroes. So let's go back and when Ukraine was new and a fresh country, and we're going to start our program with the Ukrainian National Anthem. Please rise.
Thank you.
like to introduce Miss Oleksandra Zabashta and Miss Ivanna Taratula-Filipenko.
Thank you.
you see on a lot of shows, people that have passed, and it's they show you a picture. This in memoriam is for all the people, the civilian population that has been literally erased. How many people have passed? And most are given a funeral and the rite of a funeral. But so many have been denied that final dignity of their lives. They were just there one day, and now not even their shoes are left. So in the Ukrainian Orthodox and the Ukrainian Catholic Church, both, we perform a requiem service. And in that requiem service, there is a song that is sung when a person is being carried to their gravesite. That song is Sveti Bozhe, Sveti Kriki, Sveti Besmertni, Mimi, O Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal. And at the end of that funeral service, the final song that is sung for a person that passed is Vichnaya Pamyat, which translated very simply means memory eternal. So we are going to have a symbolic funeral for all those that have been taken and killed needlessly. So, in your own mind, please think of those people and think how you personally would feel if it happened here, happened to you right now, where the person sitting next to you was not here 10 minutes from now. It's a remarkable thought. Consider that. At the end of this, please, I would ask that you do not applaud, but just reflect about the seriousness of the devastation being inflicted in Ukraine. change the pace of the program right now. And we took you from genres of religious music, basically, at our beginning. We are going to move slowly into folk music. I would like to introduce my compatriot, Mr. Diego Hernandez, who is my fellow conductor for the program this evening. Diego? Oleksandra Zabashta. She sang with the Kyiv Operetta Company, and she's going to dazzle you with a couple of her favorite pieces. The following two pieces, one leads to the other. The Ukrainian national instrument is the Bandura. Not many people know what that is, but it is a 65-string instrument that is held in your lap, looks like a giant pear, and is a cross between a lute and a lyre. It's very difficult to play. I tried, I failed miserably. The choir, the men's section, is going to sing a song that says, "Hrai my bandura, play my bandura." And right after we finish, you're going to get to hear a real live bandura player. Recognized as the merit artist of Ukraine, Miss Ola Herasymenko-Olinyk. So enjoy both. I'm sure you will.
Thank you.
Ola Herasymenko-Olinyk playing what you just heard, the Bandura. Thank you. Not bad. Our next piece, For the Republic. This song bears some explanation to you. It was written 104 years ago. It was written as a patriotic song to inspire the Ukrainian people to have some moxie, to have the nerve to fight against an invader who just happened to be Russian. So 104 years later, we're now pulling this song from mothballs, and we're going to play it and sing to inspire our people once again to fight against the same invader. Interesting how history repeats itself. The text in the song, Zadis Kupl, Piprapore Ukraine, under the flag of Ukraine, we stand. Zelensky said it right the other night. We're not going anywhere, and we will not take our mission. to keep referring to the program book because when you get my age, you don't remember a lot. The next group coming up to perform for you is really a special group of kids. These children, young people, are from the Ukrainian School of San Francisco. And they're going to sing a song that was also written a long time ago, but has been repopularized just recently. Where you lose each other on a kalima. What is that? It's a song about in the meadow. And these kids are going to entertain you.
Thank you.
Ukrainian people are not always so somber. They're very bellicose. They're very in tune to want to go to a party. And one of the things that Ukrainians sing, no matter where you go, you go to a wedding, they sing Nahayelita, which means God grant you many years. They'll go to a birthday party. They don't sing happy birthday too much, but they sing Nahayelita. Your puppy can have puppies. And the dog will get Nahayelita. We're just very gregarious people. So tonight we're going to get a version of Nahayelita that has never been sung publicly before. This is a new one, and I hope you like it.
Oh,
of tragedy going on in the world. People find refuges and havens in many places. And everyone up there came here at one point in our lives, a lot of you in the audience. And America became an adopted home. So our final song for the evening is for our adopted home. America. God bless America.
Mm-hmm.
has come to a close. We hope you enjoyed the program. Diego Hernandez. Professor Ivanna And one more person who, without this individual's help, this concert would not have happened. And she works here for Grace Cathedral. Miss Rebecca Messel. So we thank you for coming. Would you like to learn more? Would you like to sing another song? Well, we're going to repeat one of the songs. We're going to do the one about For the Republic. That's a very important song.
Thank you.
Glory Ratcha. And good night.
Thank you.